Thank you, sir. Once again, good evening to all. Myself introduce. I am Dr. Sadeshan Nair, Assistant Professor, Department of Organon of Medicine, Sharda Krishna Homeopathic Medical College. Before I starting my topic, I would like to thank IFS team, whole IFS team, for giving me a chance to present a paper in this prestigious platform, because it is a good platform. A lot of doctors, experienced doctors and physicians and education field doctors, and in all the fields of homeopathy in this group are all the doctors are country. So this is a prestigious platform for me for presenting a paper. Then I know all the doctors. I am working in Sharda Krishna Homeopathic Medical College. So I first of all thank to our chairman, Dr. C.K. Mohan sir, and our principal, Dr. Sugathan sir, and our DMS, Dr. Ajayan sir. Because in our college, a lot of 27 peripheral centers is there. This is an introduction of my topic. In out of 27, four centers are mentally treating with the mentally patients or mentally rehabilitation centers is there. Fortunately, in four, out of four, two is myself is in charge of two centers. There is on near to our college, there is known as Mekka Mandavam and Karut. Two centers is there, and two centers are managed by Christian management, and their centers are very well managed by their sisters. So the patients are taken from not the family owns, not a home. They are taken patients from the street. Okay, നമ്മൾ എല്ലാവരും കണ്ടിട്ടുണ്ടാവും ഈ അലഞ്ഞു തിരിഞ്ഞു നടക്കുന്ന പേഷ്യൻസിനെയൊക്കെ നമ്മൾ ഒരുപാട് കണ്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്. അങ്ങനെയുള്ള പേഷ്യൻസിന് ദ ആർ വെൽ മാനേജ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് സെന്റേഴ്സ്. സോ ഇൻ ഹോമിയോപ്പതി ഡോക്ടർ മനോജ് സാർ സെഡ് മെന്റൽ സിംറ്റംസ് ആർ വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് ഫോർ അവർ കേസ് ടേക്കിംഗ്. സോ ദീസ് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് പേഷ്യൻസ് ഹാവ് വി ഹാവ് നോട്ട് മച്ച് ടേക്ക് അവർ ഹോമിയോപ്പതി കേസ് ടേക്കിംഗ് ബിക്കോസ് ദ ആർ ലാംഗ്വേജ് ഈസ് ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ്. Their attitude is different because we have no idea about their past and family, because they are taken from the streets and other places and with different languages. So very difficulty to collect symptoms from these patients. We are using the objective symptoms and the symptoms present by the sisters who are managed the patients in that centers. So a homeopathy case taking is not properly done in these centers because we have no idea about that patient's cells. That is the thing. So I take a bail before the presentation. In classical homeopathy case taking is not properly done in these cases. Basically, it is a research study because a lot of patients correlated with the symptoms, we can repertrace and find out the symptoms from the objective and the from the patient's bystanders symptoms. So I take a bail once again. You did not expect a homeopathy case taking of these patients, and this one of my research study, and this is not a clinical tips because all the patients or physicians have need the clinical tips. Because they are very commonly using in practices, they are need to. So I take a bail to taken. This is not a clinical tip study. So I once again thank to IFS team for selecting me for the presentation. I can start my topic. Sir Manoj sir, can you see the PowerPoint?
Yes, of course.
Okay sir. So my today's topic is effectiveness of hyoscyamus niger in bipolar disorder. Okay. So what are the objectives from these studies? To estimate the number of patients with bipolar disorder, to correlate the symptoms of bipolar disorder with the hyoscyamus niger, and to analyze the curing rates of cases through scoring to substantiate the curing through homeopathy. So through the study, I hope to have to present that. How can we approach a case with the objective symptoms and also the percentage of cases treating with hyoscyamus niger, and what are the tools we can use for these cases and the curing rate for the benefits of homeopathy through this study. Okay. So mental health is a vital for the growth and productivity of every society and for a healthy and happy life. It is common to find people in every society suffering from mental health problems. Such people and their families face enormous challenges in their day-to-day living due to societal discrimination and deprived opportunities. എല്ലാവർക്കും അറിയാവുന്നത് പോലെ തന്നെ ഒരു മെന്റൽ പേഷ്യന്റ് നമ്മുടെ വീട്ടിലുണ്ടായിരിക്കുക അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു സൊസൈറ്റിയിൽ ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കുക എന്നുള്ളത് നമ്മളെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം വളരെയധികം ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ട് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു കാര്യം.
എക്സ്ക്യൂസ് മീ സതീഷ്, ദിസ് ഈസ് ആൻ ഇന്റർനാഷണൽ
പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോം. ഓക്കേ സർ, ഓക്കേ സർ, ഓക്കേ ഓക്കേ സർ. സോ ദ ഓക്കേ 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 ദ സൈലന്റ് സഫറിങ്സ് ഓഫ് ദീസ് ഇൻഡിവിജ്വൽസ് ആൻഡ് ഫാമിലീസ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ഓൺലി എ ഡിഫിക്കൽട്ട് സിറ്റുവേഷൻ ബട്ട് ഈസ് ആൾസോ നെഗ്ലക്ടഡ് ഓൺ ഡ്യൂ ടു സെവറൽ പ്രെജുഡൈസസ് ദാറ്റ് എക്സിസ്റ്റ് അറ്റ് ഡിഫറൻറ്റ് ലെവൽസ് ഇൻ എവരി സൊസൈറ്റി. It is time to change this scenario in the world where the social, technological and economic advances are happening at a faster pace. So mental diseases in our home, in our society is a difficult one for every us, for the society and the family members also. So psychiatry in general, Dr. John Riel originated the term psychiatry from the Greek word psych means mind and the iatro means treatment. So in lot of people's in our world, first of all many doctors have doubt what is psychiatry, what is psychology. So psychiatry means defined as that branch of medicine concerned with the study, diagnosis, treatment and prevention of disorders of the mind. Then psychology deals with scientific study of behavior of normal man and animal. In as is Manoj sir earlier said, in Hanuman study about hyoscyamin in mental disorders, and also in life history of Hanuman there is two history of psychiatric cases. Hanuman said about in 1792 Hanuman treated a patient in a mental asylum, clock and bring. Everyone know about that history. Then he also in 1799 in Altona Hanuman master treated another patient, John Carl Wiesel, and an Austrian dramatist had toured away with him a few weeks due to his violence. So this is one of the homeopathy history in psychiatric field. Then everyone know Hanuman disease, the classification of mental disease by Hanuman in our Organon deals with aphorism 210 to 230. The first type Hanuman deals with in aphorism 216. From the corporeal symptoms to mental. The firstly, the corporeal symptoms develop and it leads to the mental symptoms. And aphorism 221, the mental disease is sudden in origin, sudden. Any reasons from acute grief, vexation like that. Then aphorism 224, it's a doubtful in origin. And also in 225, mental to corporeal. Firstly, the mental symptoms started and it leads to, gradually leads to the physical symptoms start. Then the classification of mental disease. This classification based on the symptomatology, only of the symptom. Okay, then it will psychosis, neurosis, and personality disorders, sexual disorders, alcoholism, drug dependence, psychosomatic disorders, behavior disorders, and mental disorders. So mainly our discussion is about bipolar disorders. The bipolar disorders coming under psychosis. Then another condition is schizophrenia, like that conditions are coming under psychosis. Psychosis mainly mostly affected in mental level. In neurosis, the so much mental symptoms has not appeared. It is only in the neurological complaint, like headache, like that symptoms under. So only this is only a classification of mental disorders. Then our bipolar disorder is a serious mental illness. People who get through unusual mood changes, they go from very happy up and active to very sad and hopeless. First of all, the patient have some elation is there. The patient is very active. Then some more time or after some day the patient is very sad. The same patient is also very sad and inactive, and then back again. The periods are recurrently attacked. The abnormal brain structure and function may also play in role. Bipolar disorder often starts in patients late teen or early adult years. So it comes under psychosis and presently known as mood disorders. Now it is known as mood disorders. A persistent change in mood is the basic abnormality in this disorder. When the mood remains sad, the resulting clinical condition is called depression. When the mood remains elevated and cheerful, it is called mania. So one is depression and another is mania. So it is known as bipolar, two extremes. One is depression and it is mania. So mood disorders may be unipolar. In unipolar mood disorders, only depression is there. But in bipolar mood disorders, both depressive and maniac episodes are occur. So there are some etiological factor for bipolar disease. First is genetic factors. One of these genetic factors, that is monozygotic twins prevalence, is 69%, and children born to affected parents. Then the sondral monoamines, the chemicals in the brain, the residual sodium, melatonin, norepinephrine, serotonin, dopamine are diminished in depression. When we are looking for these amines in depression cases, these levels are diminished. And in some endocrine disorders, there is Cushing syndrome, hyperthyroidism, hyperparathyroidism leads to depression. And in organic disorders like cerebral atherosclerosis, neurosyphilis, AIDS, Parkinson's disease, frontal lobe injuries may produce depression. Then another is the important one, psychological and social factors. The patient has stressful life, events, obsessive personality, loss of maternal affection during childhood, loss of loved objects, loneliness, and helplessness. So these are the factors lead to a man in bipolar disorder or mood disorders. So this is very, very important. So what are the symptoms in bipolar disorders? And when looking for the symptoms, the patient have elation. Patient also in a happy mood. So the patient is very joyful, talk very loudly, talkative, and very active in all the stages. Over talkative and hallucinations. In auditory hallucinations also, visual hallucinations also. Auditory hallucination is more important because in our center, lot of patients tells lot of symptoms. And some patients are here are entering into their ear and speaking some about death and something about another person, something a person's about relatives like that. So many hallucination symptoms. Then the some of patients said about the wind is saying to that patient. Almost patient says the wind, always the wind says something into the ear. Then also next is the depression stage, sadness, and speech is slow mental activity, insomnia, sexual behavior, and suicidal thoughts. Always the patient have a lascivious thing. When the patients are in our centers, this patient completely remove their dress and walking here and there. Lot of patients are showing that symptom. Then in epidemiology, there are 46 million people in the world had bipolar disorder, with 52 and 48% being female and male respectively. In our graph is also showing bipolar disorder is 0.61% and depression disorder is 3.44%. And also anxiety disorder is also present. So these studies have some methods. So we are following some methods. We have two mental rehabilitation centers. One is in Mecamendum and another is Karod. Cases were differentiated and studied descriptively, and distribution of cases based on age, duration of illness, and symptom severity. Then comparison of score before and after intervention. This is very important because our medicine is acting or not. We are knowing only through these tools. That tools are described later. In both centers are one or two patients with mental illness. Among them, there are 42 diagnosed cases of bipolar disorders with their symptoms. These are our peripheral centers of our college. One is in Ummankot and there is Karur. So each candidate is selected and individualized according to the symptoms. I once again stressfully said that according to the symptoms, what are the patients expressed and by the bystander, and the potency and the dosage is determined only after extensive case taking. Then bipolar spectrum diagnostic scale and mood disorder questionnaire are considered as the diagnostic tool. After individualizing and assessing each case, suitable potency and dosage is found out based on the progression of the disease, overall general well-being of the patient. So pre and post evaluation is to be done using the assessment tool. Naranjo criteria is to be evaluated after the intervention. Later I show the Naranjo criteria for the evaluation. So in our hyoscyamus niger, about hyoscyamus niger. Hyoscyamus niger is commonly used as medicinal plant which belong to the family of Solanaceae. In our case taking or in our repertorization, lot of medicines coming in Solanaceae family. The first one is hyoscyamus, next is stramonium, and next is belladonna. So these are the main medicines coming under in these cases. The ancient history suggests it has been widely used in the treatment of psychiatric disease, which include mania, chronic dementia, and epileptic attacks. Crude state has the ability to produce disorientation, delirium, hallucinations, seizures, and photophobia, and even in coma. So symptoms, bipolar disorder in relation with hyoscyamus niger. So these are the basic thing we are done in our centers. What are the symptoms from the patient and correlate with the hyoscyamus niger? So in most of the cases, the medicine is come with hyoscyamus. The extreme mood changes, elevated or depleted, impulsive, impractical behaviors, habitually making foolish decisions, alternating to low high energy levels, resulting in exaggeration of physical and mental activities, restlessness, indiscriminate sexual behavior, and increase or decrease in appetite, resulting in weight gain or weight loss, too much or too little sleep, auditory and visual hallucination, seeing or hearing this that are not there. Then paranoia, decline in cognitive function, reasoning and perception, and suicidal thoughts. So these are the symptoms we are correlate with bipolar disorders. The most successful alkaloids in psychiatry were isolated the essential chemicals of various components of the Solanaceae family, the plants known for their hallucinogenic effects. So it is one of the important medicines, hyoscyamus niger. As I earlier said, stramonium is there, belladonna is there, tavacum is there, and gilsene is there. But in our repertorization or in our correlations, the main medicine coming under with hyoscyamus, and we get the more results with hyoscyamus niger. And hyoscyamus has 9 special centers of action, mainly in brain, causes violent loquacious, quarrelsome, delirium, and insomnia. Then hyoscyamus disturbs the mind, brain, nervous system profoundly, and diabolical force seems to take possession of the brain, preventing its function. It causes a mania of quarrelsome and lascivious nature. And it is a hallucinogenic plant that causes serious poison. So this is the tool. I earlier said Naranjo criteria. This is the tool for our questioning of this patient or assessment of this patient. This is the Naranjo criteria we are using for the assessment, whether it is improvement or not. Manu, sir?
Yes.
I saw the scales.
It's visible, yes.
Okay. Then bipolar disorder diagnostic scale. So these are the questions we are asked about this scale. The patient's mood or energy levels shift drastically from time to time. We are asking these questions to the patient and also the bystanders. These individuals notice that times their mood, energy level. These are the basic things of that scale. This is not important. When we are using that scale, we must give importance. They often put on weight during these periods. And some Individuals often feel blue, sad all the time, or depressed. These are the questions. And typically, those low phases last for a few weeks, but sometimes only a few days. And mark shift or switch in the way they feel, this energy increases, that things that we are asked about these questions. Then sometimes during these high periods, these individuals feel as if they have too much energy or feel hyper. Some individual aggressive like that. Then they more talkative, outgoing or sexual during these periods. Sometimes their behavior during these high periods seems strange or annoying to others. So these are the questions we are using in this scale. And we are scoring 0 to 6 is highly unlikely, 7 to 12 not very likely, 13 to 19 moderately likely, and 20 to 25 is highly likely. These are the scoring criteria. This is the questionnaire we are using for the assessment. So after giving hyoscyamus in these cases, the results are analyzed in a graphical way. Okay. The most of the cases, the cases noted in about 30 years and 30 to 40 is 6 cases, and 41 to 50 is 5 cases, 50 to 60 is 6 cases. And duration based on this is 5 to 10 years is most important. More cases are noted in these studies. So symptoms found among cases, sleeplessness or sleepiness in 14 cases, impractical behavior in 11 cases, hallucination and delusion and illusion in 12 cases, indiscriminate sexual behavior in 7 cases, extreme mood changes in 7 cases, appetite decrease or decrease in 10 cases, and loquacious 8 cases. And this is very important. This graph shows after giving the hyoscyamus niger, what are the symptoms decrease. Then loquacious in 8 cases, it is reduced in below 2. Okay. Then appetite increase or decrease in 10 cases, no changes in that conditions. Then extreme mood change in 7 cases, it comes below 3. And indiscriminate sexual behavior, 7 cases is noted in that 2, below 1 is there. Then hallucination, delusion and illusion is the most marked one. And in 12 cases, it is present after giving our hyoscyamus, then it gives below 1. And impractical behavior in 11 cases, it is also reduced to 2. And sleepiness and sleeplessness in 14 cases, and it is also coming in after giving hyoscyamus, it comes in with in 2 patients. So these are the basic things we are about this topic. And in conclusions, among treated cases, patients improved generally and mentally. The predominant symptoms associated with bipolar disease improved significantly, and homeopathic remedies helped stabilize the patient and mood and reduce the frequency and intensity of maniac and depressive episodes. Hyoscyamus is the first rate of remedy for treating bipolar disorders. So the references.
So,
no, sir.
Okay, I think the questionnaire is more important, so that if you can please.
Yes, definitely. Sir, I read.
Yes, please, slowly. There are plenty of time. Don't bother about it.
Okay. Has there ever been a period of time when you were not your usual self at, and you felt so good or so hyper that other people thought you were not your normal self, or you were so hyper that you got into trouble? You were so irritable that you shouted at people or started fights or arguments. You felt much, sir?
Okay.
You felt much more self-confident than usual. You got much less sleep than usual and found you did not really miss it. You were much more talkative or spoke much faster than usual. Thoughts raced through your head or you could not slow your mind down. You were so easily distracted by things around you that you had trouble concentrating or staying on track. You had much more energy than usual. You were much more active or did many more things than usual. I continue, sir?
Oh, yes, of course.
You were much more interested in sex than usual. You did things that were unusual for you that other people might have thought were excessive, foolish, or risky. Spending money got your family into trouble. If you check yes to more than one of the above, has several of these ever happened during the same period of time? So these are the main questions we are asking.
Then how much credibility is their answer to this question?
Sir, I take the bail, because these senders have only, we can depend upon the objective and the bystander symptoms only. In this study, we are reliable on that symptoms only. Okay sir.
Okay.
Because the patients is coming from not from home. They are from street with the language, different languages, and no background history, we don't know.
Yeah,
in spite of that, we are worked about these cases and give improve to these patients.
Then what about the overall success rate there?
Yes, sir. That is, I show this last paragraph, last graph.
Oh, it is very hurriedly gone. You just.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay, sir. So these are our counting.
Yeah.
So this is our success rate.
Could you elaborate that?
Yes, sir. In cases, we are look at these cases. 8 cases are noted with locations is more important. In spite of that, in 8 cases, when we after giving hyoscyamus, in the patient is only with 2. After giving hyoscyamus, the remaining patient is only below 2.
Okay. What about what about the potency?
So medium potency is used.
Okay. In all symptoms, all sorts of symptoms, medium potency used, isn't it?
Medium potency is used.
Why you tried the higher potency? You have not tried.
Whenever the symptoms not improving, I will go to the next potency. I started with this potency. The improvement is short. We can stay with that.
That means you have started with 200 medium potency, then went to higher.
Then go to the higher potency. I remember one case is now I give higher semestrenum.
Yeah. What was the response?
Clearly, we increase the potency only.
Yeah. Then what about the attenuation? You dissolve in water or dry upon tongue?
Sir, I give in a dry dose.
Okay.
Because that management, they have severe headache with these patients. They can easily give only through the dose in dry dose, because every time they did not concentrate on all the patients. That is also one reason.
Then I think we should know about the Hanuman's attitude towards the patient, how the doctor should consider this patient. He is given aphorism 229. I think it's very important, because this platform is attended with common man also, the lovers of homeopathy. So they should also know what was the attitude of Hanuman towards the patient. All kinds of external disturbing influences on their senses and disposition should be, if possible, removed. There are no amusement for their clouded spirit, no salutary distractions, no means of instructions, no soothing effects from conversation, books or other things, for the soul that pines and frets in the chains of the diseased body. No invigoration for it, but for the care, is only when the bodily health is changed for the better that tranquility and comfort again beam upon their mind. So that much consideration he has given to the mental patients. It is very important how a homeopathic physician should respond to these patients is indicated here by Hanuman. I think now we can go to the question and answer session. Those who are interested in this, to participate in the discussion, please go to the participant.
Before that, sir, Manoj, sir.
Okay.
Sir, before that, I present a case for you, not for asking question, for your valuable suggestions. Everybody.
Okay. Yes,
I present a case.
Yes, proceed.
Okay, sir. Sir, 1 week before, in our psychiatry OPD, a case is coming with 35 years male patient. The presenting symptom is the patient have always a pain on right chest.
Yeah.
Whenever patient is stressed or tension, that patient have that symptoms occurs. And also patient have fear of disease, and patient thinks that now he is going to die. So these are the presenting symptoms present by the patient. So I simply taken the case, and in coming in not in our OP, psychiatric OPD, so I just give the Saclac 3 dose and coming for next Wednesday. So the patient coming yesterday. Then the patient have, yesterday the patient coming with his wife for the detailed case taking. Yes, sir, so audible?
Yes, of course.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So yesterday the patient tells the doctor, I have some feeling about that chest pain is a relief.
Yeah.
Okay. So I taken a case with my internee, and then I inquired about his wife, not the patient. I asking the so much questions, and patient wife said, whenever has patient has little coryza or little rhinitis, patient go to RCC. So much fear of that patient. So a little complaint is there, patient goes to and spend lot of money and luxurious for their his disease. So much fear of her disease. So this is the main complaint felt by the wife of that patient. After that, and our patient is very angry. In the meanwhile, in their marriage, firstly the marriage time, patient is very much anger and beating her. So cruel is also there. After that, I engaged with the patient. So lot of things she said. He said he is working in abroad and he studied BCom, and he is the elder one in his family. He take care of the her brothers and sisters also. Before 6 years. Her own problem started in abroad in his company, and after that his job is lost, and now he is in residence. Then asking about the future past things, patient had an love failure when studying in +2. A lot of grief is present at that time. That lady is cheated his because. He's financially somewhat better, but seeing another person greater than this financial year, that lady goes to that man. So this is one of the hurting his life in +2 level or BCom level. After that, patient married and goes to abroad in a very high level salary also is there. Then before 3 years, he lost his job and he returned to his home. Now, after that, his wife is now compelled to another job. That time also, patient have feels of chest pain.
Yes.
So, please, yesterday also I give SL to that patient because patient is somewhat better in SL. So I never prescribe a medicine. Doctors, please suggest a medicine for this case. Also, I not asking any question. I am not asking a medicine, only a discussion. For only discussion, I present this case.
Okay.
Is there any problem?
I think cardiology after mental strain or depression, staphylococcus is the medicine, I think. It is.
Staphylococcus. Okay.
Even in hearing property, I think. So it's the time for discussion. Those who are interested to participate in discussion, please go to the participant list and raise your hands.